Hi there, Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Today I'm going to show you how I made these cards that were actually for my daughter's drama teachers. There was a production of Dorothy and Oz that both of my girls were in, and they wanted cards for the drama teachers, so I made these combining the characters of Wizard of Oz and Alice in Wonderland. So I began just by stamping Alice and her compadres on this piece of white cardstock, and this is actually a Bristol board cardstock because I'm going to be using water-based markers for coloring, and I'm actually going to be using and reviewing the Ohuhu real brush pens. Now, this is a second iteration of those pens. I had some to test out their first design, and I didn't like them very much. Well, they went back to the drawing board, and they came back with another design, and they asked if they could send me some to try out, and these were beautiful, so I think you'll really enjoy them. So after getting the main characters down on the paper, I knew I wanted to have a sentiment, so I want to thank you because they're thank you cards, and I found these really cute stamps from, I think it was Hampton Arts, and they were on clearance at the craft store for like $2.50 a set, and I just knew they were the type of sentiments that I would use a lot. I'm using a kneaded eraser to just scuff up the rubber because they are the silicone type of stamps, and sometimes those don't stamp very well when you have a large shadow image like the word thank you. It's a like a solid image, so to keep my ink from beading, that really helps just going over it with an eraser. And I'm using distress inks. I'm using the ones that come in the little bright set of minis. And honestly, if I had life to do over again, I wouldn't buy the big ink pads for my colors. I would have just stuck with mini pads. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. By using those three colors and letting them blend on the stamp, I get that beautiful rainbow effect, and of course rainbow, somewhere over the rainbow, yada yada yada, Wizard of Oz, it works great. And this set actually came with outlines, so I outlined it as well, and then I used the For All You Do stamp that was in that sentiment set, and it just works really nice. I'm glad I picked those up. The other stamps I'm using are from Crafty Secrets, which I'm not sure if they're still in business anymore. I have quite a collection of vintage storybook rubber stamps. I love vintage illustration, especially vintage children's book illustration. So anything Alice in Wonderland, Wizard of Oz, Flower Fairies, Beatrix Potter, I love that sort of thing. So I've got quite a collection of those. I don't think they're still available, but if I can find them, I will put a link in the video description. So I just sketched on the rubber brick road, the yellow brick road. And I also just did a really loose sketch of Emerald City in the background. And now I'm using the Ohuhu brush markers to fill them in. So the tips on these are about the same as the Arteza real brush pens. They're bigger than the Zig real brush pens. So just to give you a little bit of reference there. Also about the same size as the MozArt rear brush pens. And I have to say, I recommend all of those brands. They're all really good. So basically you can look on Amazon and see which one has the best price when you're ready to shop. I do have to say that the folks at Ohuhu are really excellent, and they do seem to really care when people say, look, this isn't working that great. What do you think? And they seem to be very open when customers have issues. They put a little customer care card in every order, which I think is really nice. So as you can see, the colors do blend really well. I used some brown for the edges and that golden yellow for the yellow brick road, and they work really well with the Zig markers. There you can see a Zig real brush pen because I didn't have any really pale like skin tone shades in the Ohuhu set, and you can work interchangeably. You can see how much smaller the tips on the Zigs are though, if that's an issue for you. So now if you look at the Ohuhu ones, you can see that they're a much larger tip. Since they are a real brush pen and not a felt tip pen, you don't have to worry about the ends fraying on you, and I think that's really, really nice because then you know your marker is going to last as long as you have ink. So it's not like I've had markers before where the tips have frayed before they were out of ink, and it was just, they were just kind of a waste. It's like the only thing you could use them for was inking up rubber stamps after that. So here I'm mixing the golden color from the yellow brick road on Alice's hair, and then using a Zig marker to blend, and they just blended really well together. And I think it's important for your supplies to work together because if you already have one brand and you want to try something else, you want to make sure that those brands are going to work together so you get to magnify your collection and your options rather than replacing stuff you already have. and basically going through and coloring the scarecrow as well. You can also use brush pens to work with your other water-based markers. I would just go ahead and color with like a felt tip marker first and then go in with a brush pen because that's going to help move things around. I really like that I can use it with everything I have, and also the set of 20 Ohuhu markers come with a water brush, and they're only like $16.49 for a pack of 20, which I think is a really good value. And I just love that I can mix it with the things I already have. It just makes my stash a lot more versatile. I find it's a lot easier to color dark to light as long as you're working on a decent paper. By putting my shadows in first and then blending out with a lighter color, I'm able to get those nice blends and shadows that I want. When you are doing a large area, the brush pens are really nice because it's kind of like using like a watercolor paint as opposed to a marker. You're not likely to get streaks like you would if you were just using it like a felt tip pen. And I just think it just looks a lot more professional. Now, the thing that is probably maybe a downside on the Ohuhu markers is that, as far as I know, or currently, there's only 20 colors, and the colors are pretty vibrant. And now, granted, you can use your water brush that comes with it, add some water, and make things lighter. But the thing that I would recommend, if you know you want some lighter colors, like maybe some skin tones or some neutrals, is just to buy the Zig markers individually and add it to your Ohuhu markers, because that way you get to get a lot more bang for your buck. Now, these are water reactive, so what I did was I made the poppies just by making blobs of red, and then I dropped water on top, and it gave me a beautiful flower look. Now, for the cloudy sky, I used a scallop paper punch to punch a scallop circle out of just any old scrap of paper, and then I'm using an ink blending brush and my blue distress ink just to kind of ink over it and above it, and it just gives me the look of staggered clouds in the sky. Now, I went in and colored the Emerald City, and I just kind of went in and added some just more streaks for detail, and then I decided to ink a little green so it was kind of like glowing, like the emeralds were so brilliant that they just kind of glowed in the sky. And then to give it a little bit of shimmer, I'm using a Spica glitter pen. You can use any sort of glitter pen, oh my gosh, I'm from Maine. Any sort of glitter pen or Winkastella pen to give it that little bit of sparkle. And there I am going in with a Winkastella, which actually works really well as like a glittery water brush because it will reactivate the marker from the water-based pens, and you can actually streak that up into the sky too and really give it a nice glittery look. Since I spent so much time coloring and stamping on the main focal panel there, I wanted to keep the rest of the card pretty simple. I didn't want it to detract from all that hard work that I put in. And so I basically went through my paper stash and I found this paper stack that I purchased last year that was all kind of like school days. And I found this paper with clocks on it. And I thought that is perfect because you have the white rabbit running through saying he's late and there's a clock that's broken in the play. And I thought that was perfect. So I used that to base on my card base. And this is a full sheet of cardstock folded in half. It's a very large card because I wanted there to be room for the cast members to sign it. And then I just embellished with a strip of paper that I mismeasured and had to cut in half and reposition on there. But since the focal point's going over it, you don't even know that that's not a full strip of paper there. And I don't know why I had it hanging over long on one side, but, you know, I must have been making a subconscious artistic choice there, I guess. I decided I wanted to embellish this with buttons because they're, you know, buttons are always fun, and I have them in every color of the rainbow, which I, of course, sort in rainbow order, so it was really easy for me to pick out the buttons for the cards. I simply used hot glue to glue them down because they were, you know, pretty decent size. I didn't have to worry about burning myself, but, of course, you could use a glue dot or any sort of thick, wet glue if you prefer. You could also stitch them on. It would be cute if you had some rainbow thread, but time was running short and I decided gluing them down was going to be just fine. And there you can see the three cards that I made. I pretty much did them all the same way. I didn't ink over the Emerald City on each one. I just did that on the first one because I wasn't sure if I liked it better with or without. And that's kind of the good thing about making cards in multiples. You can try different techniques. I'm using my envelope punch board by We Are Memory Keepers to make this very large envelope, because it's got to fit a full sheet of cardstock folded in half, and just used a little bone folder in there to continue my folds because I have the old style of the board and the score line doesn't quite go long enough. And then all you have to do is simply adhere everything together. I like to actually trim off the point on the bottom part of my envelopes when I am doing them because I think it looks a little bit better and it's easier to get your card in, but you don't have to do that. You can leave them pointy if you want to. And the paper I used was just some stuff stuff that I've had in my stash for a long time. I hope you enjoyed this project. It was a lot of fun to make, and I loved mixing and matching different themes to create these cards. I'll try to share as many of the supplies in the video description as I can find, and if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and share it with a friend. Thanks so much for watching. Until next time, happy crafting!